water is like energy. We can see that one energy transforming to the crop, how much yield farmers can able to get.
In our last episode, we visited the state of Telangana and saw how Aranya Farm is using permaculture to turn wastelands of eroded bedrock into bountiful food forests. In this episode, we continue on with Padma Coppola of Aranya Agricultural Alternatives and travel south to see their projects in the driest region of South India, in the state of Andhra Pradesh. The arid part of Andhra Pradesh is in the center of the subcontinent and gets between 300 and 600 millimeters of rainfall in a normal year. But the weather has not been normal here for the last 20 years, and drought has deeply set in. They've seen drought years 16 of the last 20 since 2000. Once prosperous farmers were forced to migrate away to become daily wage laborers in order to feed themselves. It was bleak. Until now.
Her family went on migration for 5 years to Karnataka state. After she receives the water, she has come back and she started agriculture again. Since last 3 years, she has been using this water for this. And also water is coming from the hilly area too. There is a drainage from there. It is reaching here with the small rains also. This is perfect location for the percolation tank.
This is just one of 65 ponds that have been built in the last couple of years around the village of Elarti. The village sits at the base of some rocky hills, so there's a large amount of surface runoff that flows down through the watershed during heavy monsoon rains, through many small drainages that cross the sandy plain. As we follow the flow downstream, we can see that many of the drainages have roadways beside them, and numerous ponds have been dug out to collect the water from waterways and road runoff. These ponds were dug by machines and are simply square holes excavated into the ground with an inlet and an outlet, where the spoils are just piled around the perimeter of the ponds. As far as ponds go, these are fairly crude, but incredibly fast and easy to build, and are literally making the difference between the life and death of this village.
Last year also in the same field, she has gone for the cotton, she has gone for chilies, no rainfall, and no crop yields, and it's like not even 1 quintal. No crop at all. So in the month of June, they received one big rainfall. By the time these two farms were full, and again, there is a 2 months of rainfall gap. There is no rain. During that time, they have given 5 wettings to the cotton crop and 5 wettings of another chili crop. So they could be able to grow these two crops using this water. And he never seen that kind of yieldings and the money from the croplands. She's saying like whatever I invested for to dug out these two farm ponds, like it in a year time, it has been paid back. The rest of the years is a profit for me. So in this village, there are 30 farm ponds were dug the last year, last summer. So all the farmers, now there is a lot of demand for the farm ponds. Everybody wants to save the rainwater to grow the good crops and get the good yields.
Aranya Agricultural Alternatives' role in this is as a lead facilitating agency for the Andhra Pradesh Drought Mitigation Project, which seeks to help 165,000 households of small and marginal farmers to gain water security. But Aranya is not just any development organization. As we saw in the previous episode, they are rooted in permaculture design and social justice. So they have a wide lens of what true resilience and sustainability looks like. This was evident when we visited Aranya's project office in Elarti village, where we were met by a group of farmers and project workers. Aranya is actually taking an integrated permaculture design approach to manage the whole landscape and introducing these concepts to the farmers that are impacted by the drought. Drought mitigation is a broad term. Soils that are rich in organic matter have a higher capacity to hold water. Lands that harvest water to grow trees and shelter belts protect the soil from drying winds and sun, sustaining more moisture in the soil. Crop residues that are composted instead of burned feed the soil and lessen carbon emissions. And Aranya is sharing that holistic perspective with the farmers involved.
So this is a plan. That is the implementation, what happened, you can see. Based on the land management units, they prepared this plan. So this is the 36 farmers' land contiguous in one place. In the same village, another patch, it's like 15 farmers. This is the map showing what is their plan in the living soil patch in consultation with the farmers and with the participatory approach. So in this patch, they propose the compost pits because after the crop season, they are burying the crop residues. Instead of burying, they could able to put it in one place. For the next year, they can use as a compost.
Even though the Andhra Pradesh Drought Mitigation Project is a conventional government-sponsored program, Aranya is infusing it with permaculture and regenerative agriculture at every turn. I wanted to check out the progress, so I hopped on the back of a motorcycle to tour one of the design areas to see what this really looks like on the ground. First thing I noticed as we toured the farms is that all of the field boundaries are built into raised mounds that are perpendicular to the slope, so that each field becomes its own water-retaining basin. This is a common practice throughout India, but here, they've begun to plant trees on these berms as part of the drought mitigation work. We found more tree plantings on the embankments of ponds and in plantation blocks of diverse species. We also found signs of wildlife, and as we got farther into the bush, the beneficial habitat created by all of this water storage became evident. We toured one of the irrigated fields and discovered that at least one farm was using a cocktail of chemical pesticides and fertilizers to grow their crops. Aranya is working hard to influence farmers away from chemical products and back to their indigenous roots. Natural biofertilizers and pesticides made from plants available to the Indian farmer. Aranya has developed small-scale biofertilizer production in Alarti village, using the seed kernels of the neem tree. Many farmers are now free from using chemicals and are returning to their very effective traditional practices for fertility and pest control. The holistic approach that Aranya is taking the lead on in the Andhra Pradesh Drought Mitigation Project is focused on small and marginal farmers, primarily the poor, landless, low caste, and tribal peoples. This is the same philosophy that we've seen in past episodes, helping the most marginalized people living in the most marginal landscapes. Traveling through this area with Padma and seeing the warmth and caring she has for the people and the land really brought me hope that the most desperate situations can be reversed with people like Padma Coppola steering the ship.
Now they have a confidence, we can mitigate the drought, we can save our crops, so like catch and store the energy when we have the resources.
Like, subscribe, and join us in our next episode when we travel south into the state of Tamil Nadu's largest city, Chennai, where 10 million people ran out of water. We discover one family's innovative and simple home solutions that kept them flush with fresh water in the midst of a mega city, mega drought.